Airtable just had a sneaky release not too long ago where they gave us the ability to manage time way more simply inside of automations. Now, because of this amazing new feature, I really feel like it's time to highlight how Airtable can function as some sort of time tracking application. Does this mean that you can replace Harvest and Toggl from your tech stack and rely on Airtable to handle your time tracking? I think so. If you want to learn more about this, stick around. And let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you get the most of your no-code tools, and Airtable is one of those tools that we use almost all the time. In this video, as I mentioned, we're going to be taking a look at the new feature that Airtable recently released. It's a new way of accessing time inside of your automations, and it makes time tracking that much easier. Now, before I get into the heart of things, though, I first want to invite you to join me for some templates. If you are new to Airtable in general, you're going to love the templates we put together. They will help you escape those messy spreadsheets and instead embrace no code. You can grab my templates at gapconsulting.io/templates. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and we are going to start building. But before we do, I want to first take us to this brand new feature. So up here in automations, you'll notice I'm in a brand new database. I don't have anything going on here. I have started an automation at a scheduled time. This is irrelevant. Whatever your trigger is does not matter. What I want to do is actually showcase where we have access to time in a way that we did not before. So if I click into the action step, not the trigger of the automation, but an action, and anywhere where I would take an action inside of this, if I open this up, you see that, yes, this is my trigger at a scheduled time, but this is what I'm looking at. This is independent of my trigger. This is the new feature that Airtable gave us. A specific time. We have access to this, not to mention the base structure, the table and field IDs, but this is what I want to talk about here today. Access to this time. And if we click into it, we see here that we get the ability to grab the timestamp of when this actual thing ran. So when the actual automation itself was performed, we can grab that runtime. Now, as I mentioned, we also have at a scheduled time, but that is merely because of the trigger we selected. So I can have an automation with any trigger now and get access in Airtable to a specific time that the automation is running, the actual runtime. Now, why does that matter? Well, let's imagine that we are going to be tracking time against projects. Let's build this out. I'm going to show you how simple it is. And I know I'm going to get this question, so I'm going to address it up front here. Yes, we have templates. No, this is not a template. The reason for that is when we create templates and share them, the automation component inside of Airtable does not get shared. And we built our templates with interfaces and backends, but not any automations for that very reason. Since we're talking about automations here, it wouldn't help you if we built a template or not, but all you have to do is follow the very steps I'm going to take on my screen here, and you can build this yourself simply by walking through the steps with me. All right, let's get out of automations. We're going to go back to the data source here. And first we need to create our tables. I'm going to start with projects. Let's get rid of these new fields here. I don't need these three fields. And we'll delete three fields. And now I'm going to connect projects to some sort of time tracking. So this is where I'm going to go in and I'm going to toggle on and off the different projects that I'm working on when I start work and when I stop work for a project. So this will be a secondary table. Let's link projects to time tracking. And this is going to be a link to another record. And we will create a new table. And so right here, I will say, look, a project is going to have multiple time records. We're going to log in and out on a project multiple times. So let's go ahead and create that field. Now you'll see that this is a very simple setup. I've got projects, I've got time tracking over here, and all I have on time tracking right now, again, it's a brand new database, so no information filled out yet. Let's go ahead and come up with a couple projects. I'm just going to fill out some sample data. Project 1, 2, and 3. And you can imagine then that we are going to link these different projects to multiple time records, as I was mentioning, and it's going to look a little something like this. Let's say we have a new time record, and we say, we were working for project one. We want to mark when we started something and also when we ended something. So let's come up with the start time, and I'll use a date field here, And a lot of times people ask me this question in Airtable. They say, I just want to access time. I don't care about the date. Airtable does not have a field that specifically handles time alone. Now you can use a date and add time to it, and that's what we're going to be doing in this scenario. But if you've ever run into a need for this where you only need time and you don't care about the date, maybe instead you would use a single select field and give yourself a few drop-down options to choose from. There are, of course, other ways to do it, but none of them are specifically fields that are created just to capture time. Sorry. But let's go ahead and create this start time. And we will also say, let's display that time zone. We'll create this field. And then I'm going to duplicate this field and I'm going to rename this one. This will be the end time. And we'll get rid of the word copy there. So you can imagine that this record right here is demonstrating when I clock in and out on a particular instance, right? So I'm saying, hey, I'm starting work on project one. Let's say it was today's date at not at 4:52, but at 4 p.m. And then I clocked out and I'll use today. And so we can see, all right, I worked for about an hour here. Now we can perform some sort of calculation here on the time entry and we can calculate the duration of that time. So I'm gonna name a field here duration and I'll use a function or a formula field. And this is pretty simple. We're gonna use the date time diff function. So we're taking two different things and comparing the amount of time between them. So let's go with the start time, comma, end time. And then how do we want to output this? Well, we want to calculate the number of minutes that we worked on this. And then we close off that function. So three different components. If you've never written a function in Airtable, it's fairly simple. You just have to follow this syntax right here. From, comma, to, comma, what units do you care about? And let's create the field and we'll see what we get. So this is 52 minutes. Now, of course, I did it backwards. I should have gone end time, start time, or a simple way to fix that is to simply multiply by -1 and it will invert that. And now we'll have 52 positive minutes have transpired from the start to the end time. This is what I need to know. And this is now a number that I can roll up on my projects. So after I have multiple of these, let's actually duplicate this record. Let's say I had two different instances where I'd worked on project one for 52 minutes apiece. I wanna know how much time is getting added over to my projects. And it's gonna be right here. I'm gonna add total time and I'll use a roll up field. It looks at my linked relationship to time tracking and I'm going to look at that duration and I will sum that function. And so right here we see 52 plus 52 is 104 minutes. That now is here on the project level and I could use some sort of multiple to that and say, hey, this is my billable rate. I know how much I'm charging, etc. Now, another thing, if you're working in a team, you might also want to track who is actually logging these hours. And that is something you can do with the user field in Airtable. This will require that you have multiple people who have shared access to this solution. It doesn't have to be to the database. We can also build an interface, which we're going to get to in just a moment. So we can see here that I could roll that up and say, ah, well, in this case, it's going to be Gareth by default, or we could set it to be a current user. So whoever creates this record by default will automatically be the person who is assigned to these different time entries. And I'm just going to go ahead and add myself to showcase how that would work. Now, the important part here is, of course, the automation. But before we get to that, really quickly, we got to stand up an interface because nobody likes looking at rows and columns. I would never suggest that you share access with your team and say, here's a nasty looking spreadsheet. No, let's build an interface so that people can access that. We simply click on interfaces in Airtable to do that. And we say start building. And we're going to build an interface from scratch, give it a name, select an icon, good to go. And all we're going to do here is record review because we want to do a little bit of a deep dive on the actual projects themselves. We're going to be looking at the projects table. We could apply filters and say only show me certain projects or group them in a certain order, etc. And what do we want to bring in? Well, let's make it all of that information for now. And we're going to quickly dress this up. Give this page a name. I'll call it time tracking. And we will finish this up. Now here, this is our interface. We are building the user experience, how we want people to see this when they're working inside of this space. So you can see here that we click on the various projects and we see the different time tracking records that are here, but I don't like them like this. This is not a great visual. So I'm going to select our linked relationship here, and I'm going to select view, and I will change it to a list. And so now you can see that we have a list of the different time trackings that we have here. I'm going to make this list now full width. So I'll toggle it on to full width, and I want to be able to see more information. So I'll select here, the actual list component itself, and I will bring more fields in. So right here it says fields, two are visible. I want to add the start and end times. Well, start time we already have, end time I'll bring in right here. And I could also bring in the duration of those times. Now you'll notice that we didn't actually name the different records that we have. Usually what I would do is have some sort of function in the back end, but in the interest of time, I am gonna skip this. But formulaically, you could create a name for these records that says, takes the project name, combines it with when you started the work, who did the work, etc. Now, the part that you care about the most is how do we start and stop these time tracking events? How do we get this stuff to go? The first thing we're gonna do is actually add a button to this whole scenario here, this whole interface. And it's gonna be the create record button. So right here you see on our interfaces, we can select buttons and add a button action. And rather than going to a website, I'll click into these button properties and do more with it. What I wanna do is actually run an automation. You remember that we have these really cool automation capabilities now where we can access the time. You'll notice that there is no automation at this point to choose from. I had this one that I started to build, but it's not actually the kind of automation we would want for this. But what I'll say is rename the label here to start trigger or start time tracking event. And because we're inside of a project already, I'm selected into project one. Well, Airtable knows that when I push that button, it's going to start a time tracking event in Airtable project one, because I'm already in that exact project. It also knows who is accessing the interface and the automation. And so since we set that default user, it's going to create me as the default user when I'm testing this out. And other people on my team, if they use it, they will be labeled as the user for that time tracking event. Super simple, right? Let's get into the automation component now. I'm going to actually open this up in a new tab because I like flipping between two places. I've got my automations on one page. I've got my actual interface in another place. So this automation number one was an example. We're going to skip that. We create a new automation. And the trigger for this automation is going to be when that button in our interface is pushed. So we go to see all, scroll down just a little bit, and we've got when a button is clicked. So make that selection here. And what is the source? Well, we need to actually head back into our interface now. So that's why it's, again, helpful to have two tabs open. And here I am in the interface, and it's going to say, what one do you want to connect to? Well, automation two is the one that we are now building. So when I push this button, that will trigger automation two. Let's change the color to blue. We can even add a confirmation here that says, are you sure? And require a double confirmation, not just a simple button click. Now back to the automation, what are we gonna do? When this thing happens, we're going to create a new record. We're gonna create a record in our time tracking table, and we want to do a couple things with it. Number one, we want to assign it to the project. We know the project because it's in our interface. So if we look here, when the button is clicked and we go to the Airtable record ID, this is the record from the project. This is the project record that is selected when we click the button. And so we're able to pass that through here and connect our new record, our time tracking record, to the project where we were when we pushed the button. Next, we need to add a user, but we already set up a default, so we don't have to worry about that. We also have a name that we talked about making some sort of formula. What we care about here is the start time. We're starting a new record for time tracking. So we're going to now bring this in, but you'll notice that I don't have that dynamic data. This is hard-coded, static dates. If I hit the gear here, I go to dynamic. And this is where it's going to be different every time the automation performs, and I get that blue plus. And here, we can bring in a specific time. The actual runtime of the automation is going to be captured here in this very date, the very start time of this record. Now, just as we built this, we could build a very similar automation that looks for a record that has not yet been ended. That means there is a record in here somewhere that does not have an end time. And then we can perform this very same function on any records that we find that have not been closed out. So we could have two buttons, both functioning very similarly, right? And they're going to bring in the actual runtime of the automation so that when we push the button, it gets timestamped. That's what we need. Let's turn this automation on, head back into interfaces. We'll publish this real quickly, and you're gonna see it in real time get added here. So I'm in project two. What happens? I say start trigger. It asks me, are you sure you want to do this? Yes, I am. And what's it going to do? The automation's in the background. And just like that, we've got a start time. This is the actual live time right now. You'll notice that I can't edit this. And that's an important feature. We could toggle it on so that someone could. But right now, all I can do is create that record. And then you can imagine how we have another button that ends that time when I'm done. When I'm ready to clock out on that project, I end the time and the duration will then be calculated. Just like this over here on project one, the durations are calculated as soon as we have a start and an end time. I know we went really quickly in this video, but this is game-changing stuff, making Airtable's time that much more manageable for all of us. If you have questions that we did not get to in this video, I encourage you to swing by our website and explore our other resources. Of course, if you got value from this, we'd love a thumbs up and a subscribe to the channel. But most importantly, keep on building.